razor blade and cut these out. I just want to get any excess paint off here. It doesn't look as though I'm doing it, but it is taking a bit off. And I can get some a bit of rock mixture, so I'm going to get some a bit of cobalt blue, which is the same colour as in the sky, perhaps a little bit of purple. I think this is, I think the fancy name is thio indigo violet, but it's another one in there, so, and have the light coming in perhaps this way, so I can pull out a little bit there, and I can add a bit of white to this mixture now, and I can get a, not enough. Perhaps even a bit of yellow with it. Even more white. Perhaps I'll make it a little bit darker on the other side. Just have a bit more this blue in here. Just maybe just pull it up a bit more. Are allowed to use your fingers. And let's put a little outcrop in there. And the next job now is to paint in the sea. So I really want to use the same colours as the sky. I really want to come on. Get in there, my boy. A little bit of medium to this just to make it a bit juicier. Almost difficult to get a straight line. Maybe link this into here so you can't see the join. Perhaps a little darker again. A little bit of ultra with it. that going downhill? Yes. And I think while we're at this stage, I'd better just draw it in a little bit, the wave. Lots of turps, a little bit of blue. Have coming in here, and perhaps a bit of a, yeah, that'll shape it round a bit, and perhaps I can just rub this out, so I've got my wave here. So now I can block in the blue more easily around it. With a bristle brush, you see, you can work it and you can flatten it and you can do what you want with it. So put a little bit of red in with this, put some shadow in. Shadow in here, into there, and now I think we'll put some dark in, and this is ultramarine, and some cadmium red, that will give you a nice dark. And also, I'm going to use some of this dark to come over the top of this. And this is going to